Friends, today in this video we'll discuss in detail about the static friction. Okay, now explanation of static friction. Now we'll go back to the Newton's law of motion, first law, second law. In Newton's first law, if a body is at rest and there is no external unbalanced force, that means there is no net force, then the body will remain at rest. If the body is in motion and there is no net force, then it will continue its motion with the same speed and same direction. This is the first law. Now, the second law states the body moves in the direction of net acceleration or net force. This is the second law of motion. The body moves in the direction of net force means if I apply a force, the body should move. If there is a net force in the body, it should move. Let us discuss it. What happens in case of a very heavy object kept on the surface? Okay, we'll consider a horizontal surface and a heavy box is placed on it. Now, a little child just pushes the box and it cannot possess it. That means the box doesn't move. When a heavy box is pushed by a little boy, it doesn't move. Now, the question is, if there is net force, however small the force may be, the object should move. That is according to Newton's second law. The body must move in the direction of net force, but it is not happening in this case. Why that is not happening, that we'll discuss. This is the box. This is a heavy box whose mass is a m. Now this is kept on a horizontal surface. Okay, this is a horizontal surface. Now I apply a force F towards right. When a force F is applied towards right, and if this is the only force that is applied, then the body must move in this direction. That means this block should start moving in this direction. It should start moving in this direction. But even if it is not moving, it should move. And if it moves, then what should be the acceleration? The acceleration of this, the force divided by the mass. Okay, this is the position 1. When the block is here, when the force is applied, it should change its position because the force is applied, acceleration will be there. It will start moving in this direction and it might come to some other place, so the position will change. Acceleration is force divided by the mass. A is the acceleration. Acceleration is dv by dt, which is f by m. I can write like this. Dv by dt, rate of change of velocity. If force is not zero, if force is not zero, that means force is applied, then A is not zero. That also means that if force is not zero, then A is not zero. If A is not zero, then dv by dt is not zero. That means dv is not zero. That means change in velocity is not zero. That means v2 minus v1 is not zero. That means v2 is not equal to v1. That means there should be a change in velocity. If the velocity, whatever is the velocity now, if it is at rest, then after some time it will not be at rest, it will be something else. That means there must be a change in position of the object, but that will not happen. If it is not moving, that means something is wrong somewhere. That means that we cannot say that Newton's law is wrong, but there must be some missing factor or something we have to study carefully. Then in this situation, we came to the conclusion that if force at all exists and the body is not moving, then this might not be the external, net external force that we can draw. If this is the force that is only force that is acting and this body is still not moving, then that will not be the only force. We know that for any particle, if acted upon by a force of say 10 Newton, it's a particle acted upon by a force of 10 Newton, and if it is not moving, then I will definitely say if there exists another force of 10 Newton in the opposite direction, then I say that these two forces will cancel out and the body will not move. In this case also, if this force exists and if the body is not moving, then I will conclude that there must be some other force acting in this body which counterbalances this force. That means that force which is opposing this force must be acting in opposite direction so that this cancels this force and there is no movement of this block. So that force which we have not taken into consideration, but that force which acts in the body in the opposite direction to this force, that force is known as friction force. That is the friction force. That frictional force counterbalances this applied force and the body that rest. Students, I was telling you that if only a single force is applied on the block, then the block should move. But if it is not moving, then obvious is that some force might be in the opposite direction acting to counterbalance the force. Now, if I see the theoretical part of this, you can see here, if force is there, then there must be acceleration A by M. Acceleration is rate of change of velocity, so this is dv by dt. If this is not zero, if the force is not zero, even if it may be minute or 0.00000 something Newton, the force is there. If the force is there, then acceleration must be there. If the acceleration is there, that means it's not zero. Force is not zero, acceleration not zero, dv not zero, v2 minus v1 is also not zero. What is v2 minus v1? Suppose that this is a position 1. If the body moves to some other place, if it moves to some other place, say position 2. Here the velocity is v1, here the velocity is v2. Then if I say that initially it is at rest, then v1 is 0. This is 0. This implies what? This implies that v2 is not equal to 0. I put, because the change in velocity is not 0, v2 is not equal to v1, that implies v2 is not equal to 0. If v2 is not equal to 0, that means if it is initially at 0, then v2 has to be something else than 0. You got the point? What I am trying to emphasize is, if initially the block is at rest, that means v1 is 0, then after some time when the force is applied, the velocity must be something else other than 0. The v2 should not be 0, something else. If v2 is something else, that means if velocity exists, the body should move, but it is not moving. Therefore, there must be some force which is acting in the block to counterbalance this force, and the force that acts on this block to counterbalance this force is known as frictional force. So that is the frictional force. That means this is the some hidden force is there that we have, we before this calculation we did not take into consideration. Therefore, we, according to Newton's law, we got the conclusion that the body should move, but because we have only considered this one force. When you consider, when we finally concluded that if it should move but it's not moving, that means there must be some other force which is acting. That force which is unknown to us, which is hidden and opposes or balances this applied force F, that force is called frictional force. And how this is applied, that we'll discuss later on. This force is always applied, the frictional force is always applied parallel to the surfaces in contact. If one body slides over another body, so along the tangent, you know, in the interface, the common surface, so along the tangent, so this is how I have shown here, this is how along this direction, along the tangent line, this force acts. If this force, applied force, is in this direction, then the friction will change the direction in the opposite direction. That means if this is the applied force, this would be the friction force, it is opposite to the applied force. That means the frictional force is also self-adjusting in nature. Okay, That is one of the property. The frictional force is self-adjusting. The frictional force depends on the nature of two surfaces in contact. If the surface is smooth, then frictional force will be less. If it is rough, the friction will be more. So this unknown force, which do exist, so therefore when a very heavy box is kept on the horizontal surface, if you push with a little force, it doesn't move. That means the friction prevents it from moving. Okay, if you keep on increasing the force, then a time comes when the box starts sliding down. If you keep on increasing the force, then a time comes when the box starts moving. So this is the condition that when the motion starts, or the when before the motion starts, so there is application of force and the block has not moved. So during this period, that application of force and the block is not moving. When the force is applied, the body is not under static condition. Even if it is not moving, the body is under the action of external force, but that means the body is impend in the case of impending motion. That means the body has a tendency to move, but it's not moving. Applied force tends the body to move, but it is not moving because of the resistive external frictional force. So that means if I apply 5 Newton force, it is not moving. I apply 6 Newton force, still it is not moving. That means if I go on increasing the magnitude of the applied force, the friction will prevent it, but then there must be some limit to prevent the motion. You cannot say that you go on applying or increasing the magnitude of the external force and the friction will be always successful in preventing the motion. It will not be so. The friction will prevent the motion to a certain limit. That means it has its own maximum value. Suppose that it has some maximum value of 15 Newton. That means if I apply external force of 10 Newton, it can prevent, because the maximum it has value is 15. So that means if I apply force any magnitude which is less than or equal to 15, then friction can prevent the motion. If the applied force is greater than 15, then friction will not do anything. It will oppose with 15, but then there will be net force, so the body starts moving. So there must be some maximum value to which the friction can prevent. That maximum value of friction, that maximum value of frictional force is called limiting force of static friction, or limiting friction, or that maximum force of static friction. That we'll discuss in the next video. Okay, thank you.